My name is Nikita Gambhir, and I am doing a PhD in plant pathology. As an understand, I had my bachelor's in biotechnology, and we had a four-month training project. So I did some work in breeding lines. So my advisor had this project in which I was interested. I did not specifically choose Nebraska, but it happened to be. But since I'm here, it's a really good place to be in. I'm researching on Sclerotinia sclerotiorum. It is commonly known as white mold, and it causes disease in more than like 450 plant species. Imagine an agricultural scenario. We have different crops, farmers grow different types of crops, and then different types of pathogens, they attack these crops. So the problem is that these pathogens, when we spray some chemicals to control them, like when we spray fungicides to control these fungi, they can become resistant, which means that they can have some changes in their DNA, so that even when we spray the fungicide to kill it, it won't get killed. So I'm here to see why does it happen, what kind of changes occur in that DNA, and is it the same for the different chemicals? I hope that it will have some practical implications. It is very important to see why does this happen so that we can circumvent this. We want to prevent this from happening. I'm not sure about returning to India after my PhD or after my postdoc, but I'll definitely return. And I am doing some genome analysis things. And I know that such kind of analysis are already occurring there, but then I can take some type of expertise from here. Such kind of analysis are already occurring there, but then I can take some type of expertise from here to there in my university that I had my undergrad from, and I hopefully will be able to use it. I work in a 435 plant science hall, and it's a good lab to be in. We have two different microscopes, a big laminar flow hood, and then PCRs. So the first two objectives of my PhD are, I have a collaboration with people in scientists in North Platte. Science is all about collaborations. You know, you can have collaborations like in your own lab. So some people will be doing some part of the project and you're doing the other part of the project. Or you can also find people with different expertise in different labs and have collaborations. I have not participated much in SCimPLE, but I think it is a very good idea, because we want our research to be disseminated to high school students, to other public in general, and we want that so that they know why the research that we are doing is important, why do we need funds, and because they're taxpaying, so where their money is being used. I would like to give them some advices. First of all, I would like to say that they should take more and more math and science classes, because it will have them form a really good foundation when they do their undergrad, and then if they want, they can in their PhDs. A good foundation is really important. In everyday life, I think they should start thinking like more critically about things. It's not only for people who plan to have science in their future, but even for everybody to make objective decisions. I think the world needs more scientists, because we have so many different questions that can be answered if we have more scientists. And I think we will advance faster if we have more scientists.